whenever a question is being asked on any of the philosopher, like in Sovereignty. So in Sovereignty, Austin, Bodin, Lasky and Cortelyon are already mentioned. So students, my name is Shailendra Upadhyay and today we are going to discuss tips and tricks to score higher marks in philosophy optional paper. So what is the tips and what are the tricks? Okay, we will going to discuss. Okay, we have already discussed that philosophy optional is a very helpful optional, especially when you are facing a time constraint during your preparation. Okay, because this syllabus can be completed only in the 2.25 months of preparation. Okay, so this is the best quality of this subject. Along with, we have discussed that philosophy optional paper will going to help you in essay paper, philosophy paper will going to help you in ethics paper, along with certain helps in GS paper 2 as well. Okay, so philosophy paper, philosophy optional, okay, is very good, especially when it comes to the essay writing, because most of the students are not able to get the message or the topic even in the examination. Okay, so today we are going to discuss certain tips like how to cover the topic and how to get good marks. Okay, so we discussed the syllabus. Okay, and we also discussed that this syllabus, especially the Western philosophy and Indian philosophy, they are okay, all the philosophers of Indian philosophy are interrelated to each other. Similarly, all the philosophers of Western philosophy are also interrelated. Okay, they started from Plato and Aristotle, and they took something from Plato and they started their own philosophy. Then next philosopher will come and then again he criticizes something about that philosopher and give his new philosophy. Like Plato and Aristotle was criticized by Descartes, and Descartes propounded his new theory, that is Cartesian method and method of doubt. Okay, but there were certain inconsistencies in Cartesian method and Cartesian dualism. That was criticized by Spinoza, and Spinoza gave his own theory of substance. But this theory of substance, that is the monotheistic theory, okay, monotheistic theory was criticized by Leibniz. Okay, so in this manner, okay, in philosophy you will going to learn every philosopher like a chain. First we will be discussing Plato, then we will be discussing Aristotle, okay, and we will be making a chain from Plato to Aristotle to rationalism, and then that particular chain will lead to empiricism. Okay, three philosophers are mentioned in rationalism and in empiricism. Okay, in rationalism three philosophers, and the final philosopher will give certain theory which will extreme in nature. And similarly Hume, here Leibniz, here Hume, okay, so they will be giving certain extreme theory that will be criticized by Kant, and Kant will synthesize their theory. Okay, so tips regarding paper 1, that is the Western philosophy, is to learn all the philosopher in a chain. Okay, we should not go directly to the empiricism or to the Kant. Okay, we will be learning every philosopher, okay, in this manner, okay, in this sequence, okay, and via sequence we will be going to understand each and every philosopher. Second point regarding Western philosophy is, especially for the examination perspective, that in exam you have to mention as many philosopher as they criticized that particular philosopher. Like Hegel was criticized by so many philosophers. Okay, so in wherever any question is coming from Hegel, then you should criticize Hegel with the Moor. Okay, the concept of Moor, you should criticize Hegel with the existentialism. So in philosophy, okay, if you are bringing more philosopher, if you are comparing one philosopher to another philosopher, will fetch you the good marks. Okay, same thing is true with the Indian philosophy as well. Okay, in Indian philosophy, there are six Indian orthodox school. One is Jainism, one is Buddhism, one is Charvak, and another one is Sri Aurobindo. Okay, so these six schools, okay, like Jainism was criticized by Shankaracharya. Similarly, if we will learn the Charvak, then Charvak was criticized by Jainism as well as the six orthodox school. Okay, so each philosopher is related to other philosopher. Okay, this is the trick in paper 1 that you are, okay, in paper 1, be it Western philosophy and be it Indian philosophy. It's if any question is coming from any of the philosopher, then you should compare that particular philosopher to other philosopher. Like you should compare Charvak, okay, you should compare Charvak with Hume. Okay, this particular thing is not restricted to the Indian philosophy. You can compare Indian philosopher, okay, to the Western philosopher as well, like Charvak to, okay, Hume. You can compare. Okay, similarly, you should criticize one philosopher, okay, via another philosopher. So this is the only trick. Okay, second, how to cover the syllabus. So while covering the syllabus, just focus on that particular thing which is written in the syllabus. Okay, that will be sufficient for you. Okay, for UPSC examination perspective, when it comes to paper 2, okay, that is socio-political philosophy. So in socio-political philosophy, so many social ideals are there, like social and political ideals like equality, justice, liberty. Okay, so simply these topics are mentioned. So when question is coming from equality or the question is coming from justice, then we will be discussing at least 4 to 5 philosopher or thinker who gave their theory of justice. Like we will be discussing Cotillia, we will be discussing Plato, we will be discussing Aristotle, we will be discussing modern thinkers like Amartya Sen, we will be discussing John Rawls, and we will be comparing one thinker with the other. Okay, so this is the trick in philosophy, that whenever a question is being asked on any of the philosopher, like in sovereignty. So in sovereignty, Austin, Bodin, Lasky and Cotillia are already mentioned. Okay, but in equality, they are not mentioned, that who gave the concept of equality. Similarly, in liberty, they are not mentioned. Okay, so we will bring these philosophers. Okay, we will bring these philosophers in our discussions, and in this way we will get good marks. Similarly, like political ideologies. Okay, so in anarchism, okay, we will complete the anarchism in detail and we will compare one anarchist with the another. Okay, Marxism and socialism. So this is something about philosophy, when you will bring more and more thinkers, especially in paper 1 and half part of paper 2 as well, like in socio-political philosophy. Okay, and these are the very generic concept. Okay, the same concept and same topic you may have studied in paper 1 or 2 or 3. Okay, like corruption, mass violence, genocide, capital punishment. But here in philosophy, how to make our answer different from the GS paper, to introduce philosophers, to bring philosophical angle, to bring philosophical angle. whenever you are bringing some philosophical angle into your question, then you will be getting good marks. Otherwise, in paper 2, it becomes very hard for you to get good marks. Okay, so you have to bring philosophers as well as philosophical angle. Okay, and the last, that is the part 4 of your paper, is philosophy of religion. Simple concepts are there. This is the easiest part, okay, in terms of understanding. But it is also the hard part to learn, because these concepts, philosophy and philosophical concepts, are very abstract in nature. So same thing is true with proofs for God. Okay, this concept is very abstract in nature, so it becomes very hard to understand as well, and very hard to learn. Okay, these concepts, again, we will bring more and more philosophers, more and more thinkers regarding these proofs. Okay, so basically in philosophy, if we talks about tips and tricks to get good marks, so my tip regarding philosophy optional is to learn more, learn the concepts which are abstract in nature. Okay, because if you are understanding any of the concept, okay, with good understanding, then it will become very easy for you to solve any of the question which will be going to ask by UPSC. Okay, so first learn the concept, along with the comparison of that particular concept, with other similar concept or other, okay, different concept. That is comparison of philosopher. So if you are bringing more and more philosopher into that discussion of your, then you will be getting good marks. Okay, this is all about philosophy. There is nothing else. Just complete your syllabus. Just understand these small concepts, because syllabus is very short. Okay, so it will be very easy to understand those concepts, but these concepts are very abstract in nature. Okay, that requires good understanding, good conceptual clarity. Once you start appreciating these concepts, then it will become very easy for you to bring more and more philosophers, more and more thinkers into your discussion, and you will be getting good marks. Okay, we will be discussing further more things at Plutus IS. Thank you so much.